More than 60 years after a birth control pill was developed for women, there is still no similar federally approved drug for men. But promising results using a new gel for men might finally change that. William Brangham has the details.
While this drug is still being tested, it has already generated a lot of interest. It's a clear gel that you rub on your shoulder once a day, and early results show that it blocks sperm production after 2 to 3 months of daily use. Dr. Brian Nguyen is an associate professor of clinical obstetrics and gynecology at the USC Keck School of Medicine, and he was involved in this current study. Dr. Nguyen, thank you so much for being here. So how does this gel work? What's the mechanism of action here?
Well, first of all, thank you so much for having me. I'm so glad to hear that there's more and more interest in male contraception. In terms of the way that this works, it is a hormonal method. And so to understand the hormonal system here requires you to understand that it works kind of like a thermostat that's always measuring how hot or cold your room or your house is. And in this case, your thermostat is measuring how much testosterone is in your body. And so if you give testosterone, thermostat will sense there's too much, in the same way that if it's too hot, it'll sense that it's too much, and therefore it'll turn off the heater. So in this case, you are turning off the testes. You're turning off the production of testosterone in the body, which will also turn off the production of sperm. What's nice about that is that we know that this factory is intact. All you're doing is you're flipping some switches so that when you flip the switch back on, then you're going to have reversal of the sperm production, and you'll have full production once again.
So the hormones that are applied bring sperm production down to a low enough level so that a man couldn't impregnate his partner.
That's correct. The majority of men actually get down to zero sperm, but we actually know that you don't need zero sperm to prevent pregnancy. Actually, our threshold is about 1 million per milliliter.
You can still have 1 million sperm per milliliter and not get someone pregnant?
It sounds a little bit crazy to say, but our threshold for actually a low sperm count is about 20 million. So when you consider that fact, right, dropping down by an order of magnitude really does reduce your risk of pregnancy.
Okay, so I know you haven't published your full results yet, but how promising does this look for being a legit male contraceptive?
Oh, I think it's extremely promising, and I'm so glad you brought that up, because we actually do have trials in the past that have shown us that hormonal methods are capable of preventing pregnancy, and so we feel very confident about that. And so as long as we can drop the sperm counts down to where we want them, then we've got a method that should be able to prevent pregnancy.
And I know you spoke with some of the participants in this trial. Did they describe any side effects that you've been documenting?
Well, certainly. It's a hormonal method, and so we definitely do talk about potential side effects that can be involved, mood changes, weight changes, changes in libido that can be up or down, acne as well. Our participants do mention that they do experience these changes. However, the question is, how bothersome are these side effects to them? And for these men or these couples to stay in the trial for more than a year, using exclusively this method on a daily basis, really is proof of the pudding that we got something here.
Dr. Nguyen, why has it taken so long to get to this point? I mean, I understand that studies were done initially on this back in the 1970s, but for all of those decades, this burden has largely fallen on women. Why has it taken so long for a male contraceptive?
So many reasons from a pharmaceutical industry standpoint, also from social biases. But my take of it is that there's also been this thought that men don't want to be involved or don't have enough knowledge about reproductive systems and their responsibility to really engage in this responsibility. I think things are changing. I would say that in this last year, we've received such a huge uptick in media interest in male contraception that it seems like there's kind of a shift in what I would consider expectations for gender equity.
Let's say all of this goes smoothly and the tests work out as you hope they do. When might we see a product on the market?
It's commonly said that anywhere between 5 to 10 years is about an appropriate timeline. I would say that, thanks to folks like yourself who are giving us a little bit more time in the spotlight, it might increase the demand. And I think that increased demand and that public awareness is what is going to drive the speed of how things go for us.
All right, Dr. Brian Nguyen at the USC Keck School of Medicine, thank you so much for talking with us.
Thank you so much. Take care.